It's called upon me to introduce the judges for the first semi-final of the men's 81-kilogram competition. They are number one, Philippines. Number two, the United States of America. Number three, Hungary. Number four, People's Republic of China. And number five, Great Britain. The referee is Mr. Jay Cowley from India. The boxers come to us from Brazil. And the Russian Federation, so please give them a warm welcome as they make their way to the ring.
We move into the light heavyweight division, 81 kilograms, and the boxer skipping his way towards the ring ahead of this light heavyweight semi-final is Yamaguchi Falcao from Brazil, preparing for his fourth contest of the Olympic Games. And his opponent from Russia, wearing blue, the tournament number four seed, the ninth ranked boxer in the world, the bronze medalist from Baku, Azerbaijan, those world championships at the back end of last year, and that is Egor Mekhontcev. Real contrast in styles between these two boxers, and it promises to combine to make a fantastic bout.
Yeah, this should be a good one. Falcao, very good indeed. A lot of power in this Brazilian. And Mekhontcev himself, very well technically, well-schooled boxer, so it's the textbook style against the more flair and power from the Brazilian.
Presenting the boxers, heading the red corner, representing Brazil, and hoping to emulate his brother by reaching an Olympic final, Yamaguchi Falcao Florentino.
The opening bell sound in this men's 81 kilogram light heavyweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, operating out of the southpaw stance, representing Brazil, and that is Yamaguchi Falcao. His opponent wearing blue, representing Russia, also operating as a southpaw, is Egor Mekhontcev, the tournament number four seed, the ninth ranked boxer in the world, and the reigning world championship bronze medalist from Baku, Azerbaijan, 2011. Falcao comes into this final having produced perhaps the biggest upset of the tournament, because he outpointed and defeated the man who looked imperious up until that point, Cuba's Julio Lacruz. 18 points to 15 in Falcao's favour in what has to go down as the upset of the tournament so far.
What's important for Mekhontcev here is he keeps that left hand high. If you watch this Brazilian, he has got a bit of flair and power about him, especially with that right hook, and he'll finish a 1-2 combination with the right hook. There it is there, look, on cue, and that's a dangerous shot. And two southpaws may cancel each other out here, but that right hook of Falcao is definitely the danger punch from the man in red.
Talked about the upset he produced to defeat the tournament number one seed and reigning world champion and world number one, as the two fighters, two boxers engaging in an exchange. Mekhontcev getting onto the front foot, forcing Falcao back to the ropes. Falcao intelligently ties his man up and waltzes his way back to center ring.
Good change of tempo there from Mekhontcev. He actually caught his opponent with a lovely 1-2. It was the left hand in particular that did the damage there. That just stunned Falcao for a minute. And the Russian, he spotted it, and that's why he upped the tempo. But he's got to make some room here.
Overhand left from Falcao wasn't too far away. But prior to that stunning upset over the world number one, reigning world champion and tournament number one seed, La Cruz of Cuba, Falcao had squeaked his way through his contest. In his opening round against Sumit Sangwan of India, he prevailed by a score of 15 points to 14. Then, in his second contest against China's Meng Fanlong, he prevailed on countback, 17 to 17. So to that point, he hadn't done anything to suggest that he had the form to overturn the world number one, especially considering that they had met three times before and La Cruz had come out on top in each of those contests.
Well, both boxers here are quite similar in their physique and the style that they use to box. Especially mid-range, they're both mid-range boxers and go for power shots. The Nita is definitely Mekhontcev, but he's getting through, he's more accurate with his work, and that may be the difference. He may have just nicked the round.
Indeed he has. At the end of the first round of boxing, Russia's Egor Mekhontcev leads Yamaguchi Falcao by a score of 6 points to four.
Yes, some good work from Mekhontcev in that round. Halfway through it, he caught him with a lovely 1-2 combination, working better with the jab. There's that textbook right hand we spoke about earlier. And there was the 1-2. Now, that definitely hurt Falcao. Mekhontcev spotted it, backed his man into the corner. Great two-fisted attack, this sustained the pressure. Then he just has the brains just to step back a little bit and try and create that room and gap. But there's that right hand again. Falcao actually landed with his own right hand. And sorry, the left hand there that came through from Mekhontcev.
Into the second round we go in this men's 81 kilogram light heavyweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red representing Brazil, Yamaguchi Falcao, part of a 10-strong Brazilian boxing team that is competing here at London 2012, seven men and three women, and his opponent from Russia, the number four seed in the tournament and reigning world championship bronze medalist, Egor Mekhontcev, who is of a team of an identical composition, seven men and three women make up the Russian boxing squad.
Well, Mekhontcev has been encouraged from that left hand that he scored in the first round. He's really got the confidence now. He thinks he can maybe stop this Brazilian because he's really going for it. I'd like to see him box more behind that right jab. There you go, and keep the punches a little bit more straighter. He has the better technique. I just think that if he decides to box Falcao at mid and short range, that brings this Brazilian into it, and he's still dangerous, remember.
Mekhontcev, in addition to that bronze medal he won in Baku last year, was actually a gold medalist in the World Championships before that in Milan 2009. That was up at 91 kilograms as he works away effectively to the body, but he's warned by the referee to keep his punches up. Remember, anything that strays below that white waistband on the shorts will be deemed an illegal blow, below the belt, as it were.
I think the quality punching is definitely coming from the man in blue. He's quicker, he's off the mark, better shots coming through, and he's starting to tire Falcao now because of the power that he's displaying here.
Falcao on the back foot. He used these tactics to great effect against La Cruz. La Cruz perhaps unaccustomed to going on that front foot and was walking onto plenty of shots. You see him trying to set that trap for Mekhontcev there, but Mekhontcev remains focused on his work and got through with a beautiful left hand. Beautiful left hand once more from Mekhontcev. And the quality boxing is coming from the man in blue. The more efficient work, the neater punching, he's been demonstrated by Egor Mekhontcev. But Falcao trying to respond and work away on the inside.
Becoming more ragged, more open now. This is better work from this Russian. Look how he's maintaining the gap, making that room and space to punch. That's a quality boxer indeed. Falcao, he's not falling in.
Falcao being put under pressure increasingly by Mekhontcev, who is boxing effectively, going both forwards and backwards. And as we approach the final 30 seconds of this second round, the work rate of Falcao is just dropping as he gets speared with a good right jab, left cross, and again he's content to cover up on the ropes.
Yeah, he's getting more and more tired now, Falcao, and I think it's because of the high work rate that Mekhontcev has set. But not only that, I think it's the punches that he's taking, the hard blows, they're actually tiring him out. So the man in blue just got to keep it neat and tidy and keep this going. And he's through to the final.
What a right hand from Mekhontcev. Out of that southpaw stance, the lead hook just knocked Yamaguchi Falcao sideways. And as the bell sounds, to end the second round, he has stretched the lead to a scoreline of 15-8, has Mekhontcev, after two rounds of boxing.
Yeah, excellent work from the Russian. He's neat, he's tidy. He has good power and maintains that gap as he's punching in the space to work. And there was a super combination there, ending on that right hook. Very impressive indeed. He's getting through the guard of his opponent and just takes a step back and just delivers that short range hook on the inside there. Wonderful punch by the Russian. Here on the ropes, again, stepping back to punch, to not falling in on his opponent, adjusting the feet and bringing him onto shots. That's fantastic work by the Russian.
Into the third and final round we go in this men's 81 kilogram light heavyweight semi-final, and the boxer wearing red representing Brazil is Yamaguchi Falcao, who is hoping to emulate his brother, who has made it through to the middleweight final. But if he's going to have any chance of doing so, he has to overturn an enormous deficit in the context of this contest now, because he trails by a scoreline of 15-8 after two completed rounds of boxing. Courtesy, really, of work like that. Mekhontcev remaining compact, remaining composed, landing effectively, but Falcao now engaging him in an exchange in a neutral corner on the far side of the ring from our commentary position.
Well, Mekhontcev is choosing to really put the icing on the cake and put in a great finish, but I don't think he needs to do that. He's a good 7 or 8 points up. He should just be boxing at range now and just seeing this contest out. Save that energy for the final. But he's showing great range here. Oh, lovely, lovely timing as his opponent's coming through.
What a left hand from Mekhontcev, and then neat footwork after scoring with that left jab. And Falcao is remaining resolute, remaining determined, but he's becoming increasingly ragged as this contest progresses, because the punch accuracy coming from Mekhontcev really has been something to admire. You suspect Falcao now just looking to produce a single punch that would bring about a finish, because he's trailing by a score of 15-8.
Punch.
What a right hand from Mekhontcev. It knocked Falcao off balance. He beats the turnbuckle in frustration as he's receiving a standing count. That was a super shot.
Perfect timing there for Mekhontcev.
Same shot again, same result. Knocked off balance sideways was Falcao, and he's becoming increasingly disheveled as this contest gets deeper into the third round. He's giving it all he has as Falcao, but he's being outmatched tonight by a superior technician, and the elimination of the number one seed from this tournament really has blown it wide open.
Mekhontcev still working with the jab. Remember, speed, power and accuracy are three aspects that you need in punching, and this man has got them all, Mekhontcev.
He had a bye in the opening round, did Mekhontcev, by virtue of that number four seeding. In his first contest, in the second preliminary round, he outpointed the precociously talented young man from Australia, Damian Hooper, by a score of 19-11, and then engaged in a cracking contest. The number four seed against the number five seed, and it was Mekhontcev, the number four seed, who prevailed over Uzbekistan's Elshad Razilov by a score of 19-15. And he appears to be en route here to the gold medal bout by conquering the man who eliminated the number one seed, the man who was being anointed, almost having the gold medal hung around his neck earlier on in the tournament. That's La Cruz from Cuba. That's who Falcao beat. And again, he's under increasing pressure as this contest comes to its end. And it's a second standing count. Mekhontcev has been absolutely superb. Remained focused throughout and demonstrated the full repertoire of his considerable boxing ability. What a fantastic performance from the number four seed, who boxed brilliantly to defeat the man who beat the man.
Yeah, one of the most impressive displays we've seen this evening in the semi-finals from this Russian. Perfect punching here from him. Good hooks, good straight punches, works well with combinations, and his accuracy, his timing, and the judgment and distance from this Russian, superb. And this man is a dangerous boxer, Falcao, but he just came undone as this contest went on, and the Russian finds the accurate work. Great display.
Well, it appears as though he won't be able to match the feat of his brother and make it through to the gold medal bout, as his brother has done in the middleweight division. They won't be able to emulate what the Sphinx brothers did in Montreal 1976 for the USA. But he's sportingly applauding the crowd and his opponent, because one suspects that Yamaguchi Falcao knows that he's been defeated tonight and will have to be content with a bronze medal. Egor Mekhontcev boxed brilliantly to book his place in the gold medal bout in the 81 kilogram light heavyweight division. A superb performance, full of precise punching, powerful shots as well. But Yamaguchi Falcao will take away a bronze medal here at the Olympic boxing tournament. And what a feather in his cap he created when he outpointed the world number one, reigning world champion and number one seed at the semi-final stage. A brilliant tournament for him, but make no mistake about the victor, and a man who looks a very good bet for Olympic gold, Egor Mekhontsev of Russia.